Okay, so what's the name of this document?
So this is a composite register for Whitstable All Saints, and it starts in 1549, so it's the oldest parish register for
1549 to 1743, is it, say?
1746.
1746, yes. Okay. Can I just have a look?
Yeah, so it's the contents there.
Yeah.
So you see a composite register means marriages, burials, and baptisms.
Okay.
That's fantastic. So you can see it's been conserved, so that's the first page of it there. That's fantastic.
And normally the public can't see these books, is that right?
They can, absolutely. So these are on microfilm as well, because it's very fragile.
But do they have to pay to come in and look at them?
No, absolutely not. It's free to come in, and we're open to the public Tuesdays to Thursdays.
Okay, so it's difficult to actually read. These are christenings, it says, I think. Does it say christening?
Yes. I think it says around Christmas, actually.
Christmas. They're actually very difficult to actually read.
Yes, because it's in a 16th century hand. So is it archivist?
So the 1500s. We've got 1566. Okay.
Yes.
See a few more pages.
No worries.
They're very thin.
Yes.
So
you can see it's written on parchment.
This is MCCCC, so that's 5 C's. LV, that would be 40, wouldn't it, LV?
Yeah, it's 1558.
1558, that's right, yeah. Yeah, 1558, sorry.
No worries. So that's...
So they don't have a symbol for 500, 500, so you have to put 5 C's.
Yeah, 5 C's.
This is a...
Yes. So you can see this is written in the third year of the reign of Queen Elizabeth.
Yeah, and this is the original document.
Yes, absolutely.
What's this margin doing here?
Well, because it was conserved, so this isn't the original document. This is what the conservator did to protect.
But this is the original document.
Yes.
Right. Okay. Gosh, it's quite difficult to read, isn't it?
Yeah. So that's why archivists such as myself and my colleagues are trained to read these hands.
Okay. So could you read this one to me for me, if you don't mind?
It's quite a difficult hand.
If it's impossible, don't worry.
Yeah. So I'm just like 16th century. So I'm going to my manuscript class next week.
Oh no, you're sure.
Look at this. But it's telling you basically the date of the baptism. It looks like somebody called Mary. So
yeah, it is quite difficult to read.
Yeah.
Sorry to put you on the spot.
No worries. So you can see this is for November. This entry is December, January.
Okay.
So it's the different services that are performed.
Yeah.
Like for the marriages, the baptisms. I think these ones are. Let's see if I can put it out there. I think these are baptisms.
Okay. Well, look, I won't detain you anymore because people can come into the. People can come into the archives and look at these themselves.
Absolutely.
But they've got to be very, very careful because we've got to preserve them.
Yes.
But obviously there was quite a lot of baptisms. Okay, thank you very much indeed for your time on that.
No, this is burials,
this one?
No, it's just continuous over time, so they're all mixed in together.
I see, so they didn't have one for weddings, they just put it all together in the same register.
Yes, composite registers came in later. Yeah.
I see. So whatever happened next, Kate, went in the register.
Yes.
Oh, this is marriages. This would be very interesting.
Yeah, so this is much clearer to read. So you can see that's from 1662.
I mean, this is really why we're preserving them, so the public can see them, can't they?
Absolutely.
Otherwise, they're just staying there without being looked at.
Mm-hmm.
So William Gillam and Edward Cooper married Susanna Cork, widowed. Married 22nd of October, 9th of November.
Yeah. Oh, this one's the 22nd of October, the Edward Cooper entry. And then this is November 9th, William Bedford and Mary Brown.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gosh, they got married in the winter as well.
Oh, yeah.
February. Well, there wouldn't have been other options available, would there? Like hotels and things for weddings?
No, not at this time. No.
Okay, well, thank you very much indeed.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.